On November 13th, 1833, in Bel Air, Maryland, Edwin Booth entered the world. Born into an acting family, Edwin Booth would eventually grow up to be a talented actor in his own right, gaining notoriety with his much more subdued and naturalistic acting style that was quite contrary to his contemporaries. He eventually married a woman named Mary Devlin in 1860, who would give birth to their daughter Edwina before dying in 1863, leaving Edwin as a widower and a single parent at only 30 years old. As he matured as both a man and an actor, he cut his teeth playing roles in noteworthy stage plays such as Richard III and Hamlet, which would become his most famous role, having set a record of playing the character for over 100 performances, a record that wouldn't be broken until 1922 by John Barrymore. Edwin Booth was without a doubt a superstar in his day, but it would be a seemingly small yet significant incident in his life that would forever immortalize him as being so much more. Somewhere around late 1864 or early 1865, Edwin was on a railroad platform in Jersey City, New Jersey, waiting for an evening train when, all of a sudden, a young man somehow fell off the platform and onto the train tracks as the approaching train was bearing down on him. Acting quickly and decisively, Edwin quickly ran over to the edge of the platform, grabbed a hold of the young man's coat, and with a sudden burst of strength, he easily pulled the young man off the train tracks and back onto the platform, just as the train pulled into the station. The terrified crowd of onlookers suddenly became ecstatic when they realized that the great Edwin Booth had saved this young man's life, especially when the young man himself called him by name. After this very incredible event, Edwin simply took his bow and went on with his life. Until the night of April 14th, 1865, when a horrible tragedy would shake not just Edwin Booth, but the entire nation. It was that fateful night that Edwin's younger brother, John Wilkes Booth, would assassinate President Abraham Lincoln. For years, Edwin and his brother John had been at odds with one another over their views on slavery and the American Civil War at large, mostly due to Edwin being a proud Unionist and John being sympathetic towards the Confederacy. When John assassinated President Lincoln, he instantly brought an unwanted infamy upon the Booth family name, which prompted Edwin to publicly disown his brother and condemn his actions to such an extent that he forbid anyone from ever speaking his brother's very name in his house. While justice was ultimately served 12 days after the assassination when John was killed by his pursuers, Edwin was still so overcome with incredible shame over what his brother had done that he decided to step away from the stage. For several months, Edwin struggled with his feelings over the national tragedy and probably started to believe that both his career and public life would never recover, meaning that his days as an actor were probably over. But his fortunes would soon change in ways he never imagined. During his self-imposed exile, Edwin received a letter from Colonel Adam Badeau, a personal friend of his and a member of General Ulysses S. Grant's staff. In the letter, Badeau related to Edwin a story that he had heard from a young soldier who was also assigned to General Grant's staff. The young soldier stated to Badeau that some time ago, he had been waiting for a train on a platform in Jersey City when he fell off the platform and onto the tracks just as the train was approaching. But he was saved from certain death by the great Edwin Booth himself. Edwin immediately recognized the story in the letter as the incident that he had been involved in and was in for a big shock. Badeau stated in the same letter that he and General Grant commended Edwin's selfless and heroic act on that train platform, for the young soldier whose life he had saved was none other than Robert Lincoln, the late President Lincoln's oldest son. The revelation was a shock to Edwin. But the knowledge that he had saved Abraham Lincoln's son was reportedly an enormous comfort to him and went a long way towards absolving him of his shame for the actions of his brother. So it was in January of 1866 that Edwin Booth made his return to the stage at the Winter Garden Theater, where he once again took up his signature role of Hamlet. According to some sources, the moment Edwin stepped out on stage, he was greeted by a cheering audience who gave him a standing ovation, making it clear that they never bore any ill will towards him for his brother's terrible crime. After his triumphant return to the stage, Edwin Booth would enjoy a long and storied career. He would once again get married in 1869 to his longtime acting partner, Mary McVicker, and after several attempts, he would successfully convince President Andrew Johnson to return the physical remains of his brother John to him. While there would be no grave marker for John Wilkes Booth, Edwin would ultimately have him reburied in the Booth family plot, perhaps as a small gesture of making peace with his dead brother. In 1881, his second wife would pass away, making him a widower for the second time in his life. Eventually, in 1888, he would convert his Gramercy Park home in New York into a private club for aspiring artists and performers called The Players, which apparently still exists to this very day. Edwin's final performance as an actor would be at the Brooklyn Academy of Music in 1891, rather appropriately, in the role of Hamlet. Edwin Booth sadly passed away on June 7, 1893, at the age of 59, and was buried alongside his first wife. He left his fortune to numerous charities that benefited both the acting profession that he so loved, and also some charities that aided the treatment of mental illnesses. In 1916, he was given a much more fitting memorial. A statue was erected in front of the Players Clubhouse depicting him in his trademark role as Hamlet. So there you have it, an incredible story encompassing the strange and tragic symmetry of two brothers becoming so entangled in the fate of a single family. One brother saving a life out of selflessness, while the other takes a life out of hate. One is remembered as a decent man and patron of the arts, while the other has gone down in history as a traitor and the murderer of one of America's greatest leaders. If you like this video, please show your support by hitting the like button and sharing it with your friends. If you're curious about my future content and want to hear more extraordinary tales, then please subscribe to my channel and hit the little bell icon so you'll be notified when new content is uploaded. Until next time, have a lovely day, stay safe out there, and most importantly, look for the extraordinary!